now that I've had a chance to gather my thoughts, I can share with you my experience of meeting Peter Weller. I had already gone to the Fan Expo once to get his autograph, but I was waiting in line for over 2 hours, so it was too long, so I had to get out of there. So cut to yesterday, and I'm going in there, and I'm arriving late to his Q&A panel, and I'm just praying to God that I see the guy, you know? So I'm walking, literally the first person I see to recognize there is Peter Weller. I see him not even 12 feet away from me, walking onto an elevator. I say, oh my God, does anybody see this? This is Peter Weller right here, there's a Robocop right here. I almost said that out loud. Everyone look! But no, I let the man get on the elevator. He turned around and I wave like that. And he looks like this, he turns, running around, he doesn't even give me a second. And I'm already thinking like, Benji, you idiot, why did you do that? You're such an idiot, just leave the man alone. So I just stand there and watch him. I watch him get on that elevator, and I am already satisfied there, right? I mean, I could leave there and be satisfied because I just had a run-in, literally, with Peter Weller. That's the man I wanted to see. So do I really need to go to his Q&A and ask him questions? Well, I might as well since I'm already there, but the point is I'm really satisfied and stoked that I just saw the man that I came to see not even 12 feet away from me. Anyways, I get up to the Q&A, I arrive late, I jump in line, I'm the last person in line for questions. So I hop in that line, and man, when it comes to my turn, I was the last person in line. I says to the guy, I've been a fan of yours since I was 4 years old, and I love the spike that comes out of Robocop's fist that he plugs into the database, and he turns into the database, he's hooked in the computer. Peter Weller says to me, you mean the prop that comes out of his hand that kills the guy at the end? The thing that goes in the computer? He says, that's a prop, by the way, that wasn't my real hand. I was like, yes, that's what I know. And I says to him, I told my dad one time when I was 4 years old, hey, look at my Robocop finger. And I did this to him. That's my Robocop finger. And then he said, the whole crowd starts laughing. And Peter Weller starts laughing. He says to me, well, I hope your dad wasn't trying to find me to kick my ass. I said, no. My dad wouldn't do that. So I continue on to ask him more questions. And I realize, I'm still talking to him on the microphone. I haven't left the microphone. My microphone's right here. I'm still on it. I ask him about Robocop 2 and why does he shoot the gun? Why does he hold his backhand up like this when he shoots the gun? I ask him the question. He says to me, it's like fencing for sword fencing. And that is, he uses it for balance because the gun has such a big kick. That's a full automatic 9mm, 14-inch length. 6-inch barrel, and he says it's got a kick almost like a 45, so he's got to balance it. And I says to him, I says, that way of shooting is so badass. And Peter Weller does the pose for me. That's the pose right there. That's what I wanted to see. So after that, I ask him one question. I says, do you mind if I ask another question? He says, go ahead. I ask him, is it true that you were talking to Neil Blomkamp about returning for a Robocop sequel? He says, yes, I haven't talked to him in 2 years. He hasn't talked to me about it in 2 years. I says, sir, would you mind if I share with you a concept for the Robocop sequel? I have an idea for it. So this is basically question three. I haven't left the microphone. I asked, so far, two questions. I told him an anecdote story, and I've asked him two questions so far. Now I'm on number three, and everybody else that asked a question, asked their question, sat down. I didn't sit down. I hung on to that microphone for dear life, and I wasn't gonna go anywhere until they told me to. So I asked my question, you know, can I share with you my concept for a Robocop sequel? He says to me, go ahead. I says to him, I says, Alex Murphy's son is an OCP Detroit police officer. Crime is high. The community wants to defund the police. There's a new drug lord in town that's selling drugs laced with fentanyl. Now, he stops me right there. He says, stop.
stop right there. That's it. That's it.
First of all, when I mentioned his son being in the story, I says to him, I says, Alex Murphy's son is a Detroit police officer. And he says to me, he says, his what? I said, his son, Alex Murphy's son. Oh, his son. He says, oh, his son. Like, it was like an aha moment. Or it could have been like, oh, I didn't hear you just, but now I hear you now. I'm not really sure about that. But he seemed kind of interested in the fact that the son was being in the story. Anyways, I tell him, so he's a police officer. They have to reopen the Robocop program. He reluctantly partners up with Robocop. He says, stop right there. Stop right there. But I did mention that the bad guy, the drug lord, has fentanyl-laced drugs. And so Peter Weller starts going into an entire tirade about fentanyl. So he's aware of fentanyl. He's aware of the dangers of it. He's aware of he's on the up and up, is what I'm trying to say. So cut to the end of that Q&A panel. I run downstairs, jump in line, get an autograph and picture. I get up to his line. I get there. I says to him, I says, I'm the guy that had the concept. He says, yes, I know. You remembered. Thank God. I says to him, now we have a scene. Me and my friend, we've written this out. And we're writers. I do short films. So I tell him a little bit more about the scene in the movie. And he says, you should pitch that to the studios. Now, he could have been just saying, being nice, but did he really have to be that nice? I mean, he could have just said, oh, that sounds cool. Sign. There you go. Have a good day. But no. So he says to me, you need to pitch it to the studios. And I'm thinking like, what? Pitch it to the studios? How do I do that? So I ask him, how do you do that? He says, you need to find out who owns the rights to it. Find out who owns the rights to it and get in touch with them and sell your pitch. Find out if MGM owns them, whoever. So I'm thinking like, he must just be being nice, you know? And I get in position to take my picture with him. I take the picture, I get the autograph, and he's already talking to the other person, and I say, okay, it's time to go. So I say, thank you. And I said to him, thank you very much. And he looks at me and says, thank you, have a good day, and I encourage you to write it. I encourage that. And I'm thinking like, okay, don't, Mr. Weller, don't give me a mission, and then don't think that I'm not going to do it, because I'm going to do the mission. My first mission was to come and meet you, Mr. Weller. And now you're telling me I should write it and pitch it to the studio? Darn tune, I'm going to write it and pitch it to the studio. So that's what me and my friend are going to do. We're researching hard, taking a break out of our normal busy lives. We're going to take this seriously. We're going to pitch it. We already have some stories written up. And the concepts. We got the setting in mind. We have the actors in mind. I might audition to play Murphy's son. We don't know. Question is, was Mr. Weller being serious? Or was he just being nice? But, ain't got nothing else to do, so might as well just give it a shot, you know?